गुड इवनिंग स्टूडेंट्स, यस होप यू ऑल आर फाइन इन दिस कोरोना क्राइसिस। सो बूस्ट यूअर इम्यूनिटी बाय टेकिंग सेल्फ केयर गाइडलाइंस व्हिच इज इशूड बाय द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ आयुष, दैट इज बाय ड्रिंकिंग वार्म वाटर थ्रू आउट द डे, डेली प्रैक्टिस ऑफ योगासना, प्राणायाम एंड मेडिटेशन फॉर एटलीस्ट 30 मिनट्स, एंड द यूज ऑफ स्पाइसीज व्हिच आर एंटी इन्फ्लेमेटरी, एंटीबायोटिक लाइक टर्मरिक, क्यूमिन, कोरिएंडर एंड गार्लिक एक्सेट्रा इन एक्सेस क्वांटिटी। सो लेट अस स्टे हेल्दी एंड सेफ। ओके, कमिंग टू द क्लास, कंटिन्यूएशन ऑफ द योनि व्यापार टॉपिक। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अनदर योनि व्यापार, दैट इज द उपप्लुत योनि व्यापार। उपप्लुत योनि व्यापार, इट इज मेंशन बाय द चरक एंड द वाग्भटास। So according to Charaka, the Nidana and the Lakshanas goes like this: Garbhanyah Shleshmalabhyasa Chardi Nishwasa Nigrahat Vayuho Krudham Kapham Yonim Upaniya Pradushayet Pandum Satodam Masravam Shweta Sravati Vakapham Kafavata Maya Vyapta Sasyad Yonir Upapluta. This is mentioned in Charaka Chikisasthana 30th chapter. And according to Vagbhatas, the quotation is vata shleshma maya vyapta shweta pichila vahini upapuluta smruta karnini. So this is the quotation mentioned by the charaka as well as the vagbhata. So the meaning of the charaka's quotation is, charaka has given here the two main nidanas of upapuluta yoni vyapad. He says that one is when the garbhini consumes the shleshmala abhyasa, that is the shleshma vartaka ahara vihara consumed by the garbhini or a pregnant woman, and second nidana is the vega dharana, chardi nishwasa vega dharana, that is when a pregnant lady consumes the diet and indulgence in the mode of life which is capable of vitiating the kapha dosha. Shleshmala abhyasa means by the consumption of shleshma vardhaka, that is a kapha vardhaka ahara and vihara by a garbhini or a pregnant lady. And second nidana is chardi nishwasa nigrahana, that is a vega dharana or suppressing the desires of chardi, that is the vomitings, and the nishwasa or inspiration. Then what happens because of these two main nidanas? The vayu, see, with the vega dharana, what happens? The vayu is getting aggravated, and by the consumption of kapha vardhaka ahara vihara, kapha is getting vitiated. So what happens? The vitiated vayu withholding the kapha, it reaches the yoni and produces different abnormalities. Due to this, there are certain symptoms produced inside the yoni, like different types of vaginal discharges, like either yellowish vaginal discharges along with the pricking pain, or else white mucoid discharges. So afflicted with the features of kapha and the vata, this condition is called as upapluta, is the opinion of Charaka. So Charaka says that as it is afflicted, upapluta, the meaning of upapluta is overflowed, invaded or afflicted. So this, in this condition, the yoni is completely afflicted or overflowed. See, though the doshas always invade the yoni in all the conditions, however, here the special mention of the word indicates that here the pain, pinkish or whitish or thick and thin discharges, etc., the features of vata and kapha invades the entire yoni or the vaginal canal. And here, Vagbhatas, they have given almost similar description, but they have not restricted it to the pregnant woman only. So Vagbhatas have not mentioned the only to the garbhini, that means according to Vagbhatas, this can occur in any woman, but Charakas has restricted this condition to the pregnancy or the pregnant ladies. So according to Charaka, the doshic involvement and is same, like it is caused by vata and kapha. And according to Vagbhata also, the doshic involvement is same. Symptoms are also similar, but Charaka considered it as a garbhini vyadhi, or it is a disease of a pregnant woman, whereas the Vagbhata considered as this disease can occur to any woman, not only the pregnant lady. So here, coming to the correlation, as the meaning of upapluta is overflowed or invaded or afflicted, so here the entire yoni is afflicted with the features of vata and kapha. So thus it appears to be a description of the vaginal thrush caused by different organisms like Candida albicans or Monelial vulvovaginitis. Though the disease can afflict any woman, however, the pregnant women are more susceptible for this infection. That's why Charaka has specifically mentioned the Garbhini, because the pregnant ladies are more susceptible to get this infection. There are great individual variations in the clinical features, as one may have the pain and tenderness and itching. Yes, the lakshanas are given like this. Pandum sa todam asravam is the pandum is the whitish, todam is with the pain, pricking pain, srava will be there, shweta sravati va kapham, or sometimes the only mucoid discharges, whitish mucoid discharges will be there. Kafavata maya vyapta sa syad yoni upapluta, as it is afflicted completely with the vata and kapha dosha, it is to be termed as the upapluta yoni vyapadam. So entire vaginal canal is covered with the thick white discharges. Thus all the clinical features of the Monelial vulvovaginitis. Condition called as Monelial vulvovaginitis, it looks similar to the description of upapluta yoni vyapada. So correlation of upapluta yoni vyapada is with the vaginal thrush caused by the Monelial vulvovaginitis or the Candida albicans. So coming to the next yoni vyapada, which is the paripluta yoni vyapada. Paripluta yoni vyapada nidanaivam lakshanas. So first, coming to the Charaka's version, the quotation of Charaka goes like this. Pittalayah nrusamvase shvatu udgara dharanat pitta samurchito vayur yonim dushayati striyah shuna sparshakshama sa arti nila pitam asruk sravet shroni mangshana prushtarti jorartayah paripluta. This is mentioned by Charaka in the Charaka Chikisa Sthana 30th chapter. And according to Sushruta, he says, paripluta bhavati gramya dharme रुजा भृशम चतस्रिश्वापी चाद्यासु भवत अनिल वेदना. एंड दि वाग्भटाज हैव मेंशन लाइक दिस. पित्तलाया नृसंवासे श्वेतुद्गार धारणात् पित्तयुक्तेन मारुता योनिर्भवति दूषिता शूना स्पर्शाक्षः सार्ति नीला पीता स्रवाहिनी वस्तिकुक्षी गुरुत्वम अतिसार आरोचक कारिणी श्रोणिवंशण रुक् दोषात् ज्वराकृत स परिप्लुता. So this is the Lakshanas, Nidana and Lakshanas by different Acharyas. So coming to first explanation of Charaka. Here Charaka has written that the Nidana is mentioned by Charaka as when a lady of Pitta Prakriti, means a woman of Pitta Prakriti, consumes Pitta Vardhaka Ahara Vihara. Pittalayah anrusamvase shvatudgara dharana. So here again the two main nidanas are mentioned according to Charaka. First nidana is when a pitta prakriti woman consumes pitta vardhaka ahara vihara, or the diet and the mode of life which aggravates the pitta dosha. And second nidana is the vegadharana, which vegadharana? Shvaitu and udgara. Shvaitu and udgara vegadharana, that is when she withholds the natural urges of shvaitu, that is sneezing, and the udgara, erectations, belching. So at the time of coitus, then what happens, the vitiated pitta getting mixed with the aggravated vayu because of the vega dharana, it reaches the yoni or the reproductive system of a female and produces its abnormalities. And specifically what it does is the yoni becomes inflamed. Shuna means the total inflammation of the yoni occurs, it becomes reddish, inflamed and tender. Sparshakshama, sparshakshama means unable to tolerate the sparsha or the touch, that means tenderness. Pain on touch is called as tenderness. So that here the word sparshakshama indicates the tenderness. Shuna sparshakshama. Then sa arti means with pain there will be discharges of different colors like neela pitam asruk sravet. So with pain, what happens here? Along with the pain, there will be discharges of yellowish or bluish color of menstrual blood. And she also suffers from pain in the lumbosacral region, groin region, back pain and the fever. Shrodi, Vangsha, Prushta, Arti. So in all these regions, she will get the pain and jara. Jara, that is the fever will be there. Generalized fever is also be seen in cases of Paripluta Yoni Vyapad, which is mentioned by Charaka. So here the Nidana is Pittala, that is the Pitta Prakriti woman, men consumes Pitta Vardhaka Haravihara and withholds the urge of Shwetu Udgara at the time of intercourse. then her vitiated pitta with holding the vitiated or aggravated vayu, it vitiates the entire reproductive system of women, or the specifically the yoni pradesha, and it produces certain symptoms in the yoni like shunas, inflamed yoni, tenderness in the yoni, and with pain there will be a bluish yellowish color menstrual discharges, and there will be pain in the region of shroni, vamshada, prushta, etc., along with the fever. So this yoni vyapad is termed as parikluta yoni vyapad by Charaka. And according to Sushruta, he gives a separate different version. He says that Pariplutayam Bhavati Gramya Dharmena Ruja Brusham. The only main symptom of Pariplutta, according to Sushruta, is the Gramya Dharma Ruja. Ruja here means the pain. The Gramya Dharma is meaning is the intercourse. So the Lakshana of Pariplutta Yoni Vyapada is pain during the intercourse or the dyspareunia. And along with that, he further says that Chatusrishu Api Chadyasu Bhavat Anila Vedana. That means as here there will be different types of Anila Vedanas will be there. That Vatika Vedanas can also be seen here. So this the only symptom, the only main symptom as per Sushruta is the condition of Parikluta Yoni Vyapada is characterized with the severe dyspareunia or Gramya Dharma Ruja. And besides, other features of the Vata will also be seen like Doda Veda type of different types of pain. Vata Nila Vedana or Vata Vedana are also present. This is according to Sushruta. And according to Vagbhata, both the Vagbhatas have followed Charaka. However, they have included certain symptoms, sign and symptoms, 3 or 4 extra Lakshanas are mentioned. Those are heaviness in the regions of bladder and the lower abdomen, Vasti Kukshi Guruta, this is the additional symptom added by Vagbhata, Atisara Arochaka, Atisara is the diarrhea and Arochaka is the anorexia. So these 3 extra Lakshanas are added by the Vagbhata. Whereas other authors like Madhav Nidana, Bhava Prakasha, Yoga Ratnakara, they have followed the Sushruta Acharya. And in the Madhukosh commentary, it is explained that since in this condition, the features of Vata, that is pain, etc., are present with extreme severity, which means Pluta, and all around means Pari, that is the entire internal and the external reproductive organs, hence it is termed as Pari Pluta, that is Pari Plutayam Miti. Pari sarvataha vata vikare. Pari means the meaning of pari sarvataha vata vikare. Means here the pain will be there. Pari means all around. Pluta means the severity or extremely severe. Plutatvat pluta sagnya. Pari plutayam bahya abhyantara vata vedana abhiryuktayam gramya dharma rug prusham ityarthe gramya dharmena ruchi prusham iti pathantara. Tatra Ruchi Abhilasha Gramya Dharma Maitune. This is mentioned by the Madhukosh Tikakara. The commentator Madhukosh, he says that in this condition there will be like Pari means all around, Pluta means a severe, extremely severe. So in the entire internal and external reproductive organs there will be severe pain, or pain will be there, or different Vatika types of pains are present in the entire internal as well as the external reproductive organs. Hence it is called as Parikluta. And besides pain during the coitus, it is substituted with the liking of the coitus, mentioned it in an another version. So in certain different text, instead of ruk, Ruja means pain, they have mentioned Ruchi. Ruchi means liking. So both are different things. But here it is better to consider it as a Ruk, not the Ruchi. So coming to the comments, in the description of this disorder, the opinion of Charaka and Sushruta are quite different. So you can find the different Lakshanas. They differ in the same Lakshanas. Even though the names are same, mentioned by Charaka and Sushruta, but the Lakshanas of the Parikluta Yoni Vyapada, according to both authors, are quite different. Charaka says that it is due to Vata and Pitta having inflammation, fever, backache, etc. symptoms. While Sushruta has mentioned it to be due to the Vata, etc., Vata having only one symptom, which is the Gramya Dharmena Ruja or the dyspareunia. So only one symptom is mentioned by Sushruta. Along with that, he has said that Vatika Vedanas will also be there. If the explanation of Madhukosh is to be taken into consideration, then it would appear identical to a condition called as vaginismus. Vaginismus, here the involuntary contractions or the spasm of the vagina occurs, leading to the dyspareunia. Because in acute vaginismus, there is a muscular spasm of the thighs, vulva, vaginal canal associated with the severe dyspareunia. And among different causes of dyspareunia, inflammation of the Bartholin glands, fallopian tubes, ovaries is also one. So in acute inflammation of these organs, all the clinical features described by Charaka may be noted, besides due to the colonic irritation caused by the pelvic hyperemia, diarrhea, etc. symptoms which are added by the Vagbhatas may also be seen. So in all the inflammatory conditions, Pitta is vitiated. As the disease is caused by the Gramya Dharma or the coitus, hence this condition could be a condition of gonococcal infection of the reproductive organs. So this condition can be correlated with the gonococcal infection of the reproductive organs. On the basis of the above description, it can be inferred that the Charaka etc. have described acute inflammatory stage of gonococcal infection, while Sushruta has described the late stage of the same condition, in which the dyspareunia is present due to the chronic salpingo-oophoritis. Vaginismus described in the Madhukosha commentary may be due to the psychological abnormalities present in any chronic disease or the chronic dyspareunia. Thus, it appears that all the classics have described the different stages of a similar or the one and the same disease, that is the infection specially caused by the gonococcus, that is the gonococcal inflammation of the reproductive organs in the early stage, late stage, etc. So according to Charaka, it simulates with the acute or the early stage of the gonococcal infections leading to the chronic salpingo-oophoritis, and the Sushruta's late stage where there will be dyspareunia. And according to Madhukosha, vaginismus can be correlated. Again, the cause may be the infection. And altogether, this condition or the Paripluta Yonimyapath condition can be correlated with the gonococcal inflammation of the reproductive organs. So this is all about Paripluta Yonimyapath. So coming to the next Yoni Vyapada, it is called as Udavartini Udavritta or Udavarta Yoni Vyapada. So according to Charaka, the quotation goes like this: Vega Udavarta Nath Yonim Udavarta Yate Anilaha Sa Rugartha Rajah Krishne No Udavrittam Vimunchati Artave Sa Vimukte Tu Tatshanam Labhate Sukham Rajaso Gamana Urdhvam Igneyat Udavartini Budaihi. This is mentioned in Charaka Chikisa 30th chapter. And next, according to Sushruta, the quotation is Safe Nilam Udavarta Raja Krishna Munchati Chatasrishwapi Chadhyasu Bhavanta Nila Vedana. And according to both the Vagbhatas, Vego Udavartanam Yonim Prapidayati Marutaha Safe Nilam Rajaha Krishrat Udavrittam Vimunchati Iyam Vyapat Udavritta. So coming to the description, meaning of it, Charaka says that due to the movement of the flatus etc. natural urges in the reverse direction. So the Nidana of Udavartini Yonivyapada mentioned by Charaka is Vego Udavartanam. Udavartanam is in the reverse direction, that is in the upward direction. Usually the Vegas, the movement of the natural vega should be in the downward direction. Anulomana should be there. But here what happens? Because of the aggravated vayu or the apana vayu, it moves in the reverse direction. It takes the vegas to the upward direction, which is called as the Vego Udavartana. So because of the Vego Udavartana, that is the movements of the vegas, flatus, etc., natural urges in the reverse direction, the aggravated vayu, especially the apana vayu, moving in the reverse direction, it fills the yoni with the vata. Then this yoni or the uterus, seized with the pain, initially throws or pushes the raja or the menstrual blood upwards. See, this aggravated vayu, because vegas are going in the opposite direction, So it takes the menstrual blood to the upward direction instead of taking it to the downward direction. First it takes the blood to the upward direction, then it discharges it with a great difficulty. So the lady feels relief immediately following the discharge of menstrual blood. And since in this condition the raja moves upwards and in the reverse direction, it is called as Udavartini. So Chakrapani commentator, he says that, he gives commentary, says that Yonim Udavarta Yate Iti Yonim Udavarta Vatam Karoti Udavrittam Iti Urdhvanitam. Udavrittam Iti Urdhvanitam is when it goes in the upward direction. That's what is called as Udavartam. Vikarena Rajasa Urdhva Gamanat Udavartini Ityuchate. Vikarena Rajasa Urdhva Gamanam Udavartini Ityuchate. As in this condition, the Raja goes into the upward direction first. That is Rajaha Urdhva Gamanam, in the condition of the disease Vikara, in which the Raja goes into the upward direction. That's why this condition is termed as Udavartini Yoni Vyapat, is the commentary given by Chakrapani. Since in this condition the Raja moves upwards and in the reverse direction, hence it is called as Udavartini. So next is according to Sushruta. He says that Sushruta gives a very short description. He says that besides the painful frothy menstruation, there are other features of Vata, body ache, general malaise, etc. is also seen. Safenilam Raja Kruchurna. Sushruta also gives the same thing. Raja Kruchurna means the painful menstruation or the dysmenorrhea will be there with the frothy discharges. And here Bhavant Anila Vedana. Here you will find the different types of Vataja pains will also be there. Both the Vagbhadas have followed the Charaka. However, Hindu commentator, he says that the discharge of the clotted blood, he has added the discharge of the clotted blood. Here the nature of the menstrual blood is said to be clotted. Here he has mentioned that Baddha Rajasa Rajo Raktam. The quotation goes like this. Hindu Tikakar, he says, Vega Udavartanam Adho Vatadi Vega Dharanam Nimittam Urdhvam Vayur Yonim Prapidayate Sapidita Satyudavartam Baddha Rakto Rajasam. Hindu Tikakar says Baddha Rakto Rajasam. So Hindu has added that the Baddha Raktam is here the discharge of clotted blood occurs with the pain. Madhav Nidhan and Bhav Prakash books have followed Sushruta Acharya, and in the Madhukosh commentary, all around movement of Vayu is said to be the cause of the pain. Madhukosh says that the cause of pain is the Vayu Sa Yathoti Samantha Vartanam Vayu Sa Yathoti, means because of the all around movement of the Vayu, there will be the pain. Books like Yoga Ratnakara have added the discharge of frothy menstrual blood associated with the kapha with difficulty. So Yoga Ratnakara, the quotation is like this. Safenilam Udavarta Rajah Krishnena Munchati Satu Yoni Kapho Kafena Udavartam Cha Munchati. So he says that with kapha, frothy menstrual blood with kapha is discharged here in this condition. So coming to the comments, the condition Udavritta or Udavartini resembles the description of almost all types of dysmenorrhea. On the basis of symptoms of immediate relief of the pain following discharge of menstrual blood given by Charaka. Charaka says that Vimukte, the last line Charaka, he says that Artevesa Vimukte tu Tatshanam Labhate Sukham. Means Tatshanam Labhate Sukham means the woman gets relief of the pain after the discharge of the menstrual blood. So by this symptom, that is the immediate relief of pain following the discharge of menstrual blood given by Charaka, it appears to be nearer to the true or spasmodic dysmenorrhea. So it can be correlated with the true or spasmodic dysmenorrhea. Among various theories regarding the origin of pain in the spasmodic dysmenorrhea, incoordinate muscle action of uterus as a whole, more likely due to imbalance in the autonomic nervous system of the muscles, is given the maximum importance. Overactive sympathetic leads to the hypertonus of the circular fibers of the isthmus and the internal os, as well as the irregular contractions of the remaining muscle fibers of the uterus. The menstrual blood, normally going downwards, is pushed upwards due to the hypertonicity or the spasm of the isthmus and the internal os. So it is pushed upwards, or which condition has been clearly described by the charaka. Incoordinate or the irregular contractions of the myometrial muscle fibers have been explained as all around movements of the vayu in the Madhukosh commentary. And the discharge of clotted blood mentioned by Indu may be the description of special form of spasmodic dysmenorrhea characterized with the expulsion of big clots of the blood. If the association of kapha described by Yoga Ratnakara is taken as an association of the mucous membrane or endometrium, it can be correlated with another form of the spasmodic dysmenorrhea, which is called as a membranous dysmenorrhea. There the endometrium is shed out without the breakdown of the endometrium occurs. So in total, this condition of Udavartini, Udavarta or Udavritta Yoni Vyapada can be correlated with the different types of dysmenorrhea, especially the spasmodic dysmenorrhea. So this completes about the Udavartini Yoni Vyapada. Shlokas, quotation by hartation is must, especially the charakas and Sushruta's quotation of each yoni vyapad is very very important. You should by heart all the quotations of each and every yoni vyapada. It's very important for your exam purpose. Okay, stay safe. Thank you.